Hey, this is the Stinger here, and one of my favorite things about the Ultimate Warrior was he used to take tuna and orange juice, put it in a blender, guzzle the whole thing down, and say, "Yeah, I got my vitamin C, and I got my protein all in one."
Toward the end of my schooling, and I knew when I got out I wanted to continue with bodybuilding. I'd done good there. I won the Mr. Georgia in 1984. I took a trip to California, and one of the owners of Gold's Gym, Ed Connors, called and said, "Look, there's a guy out here that's putting together a wrestling thing. Would you be interested?"
Ed one day came into this gym, and he wanted me to let this big dude come in and train. He had a freaky physique, and when he walked through the room or through the gym or anywhere else, people went, "Ugh."
I went to California, and Steve Borden, Sting, he was one of the four guys that were being trained.
Rick Bassman came in with this group, and that's where it all started, really.
We were so positive about things, we took some pictures, put together a flyer, and sent it around.
We sent out press kits. It was about 3 days later, but we got a phone call back from Jerry Jarrett.
And Jerry Jarrett was Mid-Southern, it was called.
He said, "Yeah, I'm looking at a picture, and I got four guys in this picture," but he says, I can only use two of you." And he goes, "I want the two guys to the far left in this picture I'm looking at." There was only one picture we had of all four of us like that.
The Blade Runners!
Me and Steve, as a tag team, we experimented with mascara and stuff like that. I had a flat top as one of the Blade Runners. And we'd do the eye thing, painted the lips black.
When the Ultimate Warrior was Rock of the Blade Runners, I truly believe he had a vision for his future.
Think about Warrior, he was strong-willed, and he wanted to do things his way on his terms.